So I would say this. Our young ladies played with an incredible amount of toughness and, I thought, fearlessness today. South Dakota State is a great, great basketball team, and somehow we were able to kind of slow them down, and they were able to do the same to us. And so I thought it came down to making some big plays, and I thought our young ladies were able to do that. And these three young ladies who opted to come back for their super senior year, COVID senior year, whatever you want to call it, came back for a moment like this and to have this opportunity. But just because you want to doesn't mean you get to. But it's a testament to them, to their character, to their toughness, to all the time that they've put in to get back here. So I couldn't be more excited for them. I love them to death. Wish they could stay for another year. Can we talk to the NCAA and petition? You know, I think they've done just a great job of not only leading by example and vocally, but also leading and making sure they're taking care of their bodies, because this was a tough stretch, a really tough stretch, 3 games in 4 days, and then also adding the game before that, you know, when we had to go make up the game at Western Illinois. It's hard to do that. And so I thought they did a tremendous job of kind of willing themselves to this point in time.
Go ahead with questions for the student athletes.
Bailey Zobke, Yankton Press Indiacotan. Hannah, you knew that this was going to be a defensive battle. You guys pride yourself on defense. You know, what was kind of the key for you guys defensively to hold them to such a low shooting percentage and score overall?
You know, defense, like you said, is what we pride ourselves in. And last night, just remembering that we need to be able to guard one-on-one and not rely on each other to help and excel. And I think our team did a great job of that while still helping when they could.
Michael McClure, Argus Leader. Chloe, obviously it was really back and forth towards the end, and there was a lot of misses back and forth, but, you know, was there any point of the game that you felt comfortable with the flow that, you know, if it stuck this way, you guys can pull it out?
Against State, it's hard to feel like that, you know, because they're a great team and can really score the ball really efficiently, so you never really feel safe, I think. But I felt comfortable, and I trusted that you know, we were going to make the plays that we needed to, guard people inside, and then get shots and execute on offense when we needed to as well.
Barry Poe, Sioux City Journal. Hannah, explain how you can go 6 minutes without a field goal and still increase your lead and hang on to win this game.
I didn't even realize we did that. I think, once again, that speaks to our defense and just relying on that to carry our offense. That if you do notice that can affect your flow, but I don't think any of us on the floor felt that, and that's a testament to how we play.
I think it's a testament to Hannah and Kaya holding Maya Sellin, who's been real hot, over 10 in field goals. That's amazing.
And Liv, for you guys, three straight conference championships. What's so special about this group of this team to kind of win three in a row like that? It's a unique feat.
It is unique, especially because we've had different groups. You know, we've always been together, but we've had people leave and people come in. And that experience of each group is kind of different. You each have a different flow, but things stay the same. I think that's, you know, carried us through for these 3-for-3.
Hannah, obviously this was a goal for the year, but, you know, obviously now that you know that you're moving on, I guess, what are some of the goals for the future now?
I mean, I don't want to put a ceiling on what we're trying to do. Obviously, every game we want to go out there and win and compete and play at our highest level. So I think for us, it's just we need to focus on us and, you know, fixing the mistakes that we did make, even though we did win today.
Any other questions for the student athletes? All right, congratulations, Chloe, Liv, and Hannah. You guys can head back to the locker room.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Kind of tough, you know. Tough crowd.
Go ahead with questions for Coach.
Dawn, obviously the defensive effort was a total team effort, but what specifically do you think impact Hannah had in there? I mean, the block shots, the rebounds, it just looked like the lane was a no-go for South Dakota State with her in there.
Yeah, Hannah has a huge impact on the game on both ends of the court. Her size, her length, you know, her understanding of when to come over and help make life difficult. You know, I think she really was a force to be reckoned with. And certainly late in the game, when, you know, there was a 6-point differential late in the game. You never did feel safe at that point in time because State can score so fast. And there was a possession where they shot it, and Kaya jumped as high as she could jump, and Kaya can really jump. And Hannah went to go get it, and somehow Chloe Lamb came up with it. So we were laughing about that. And then the next one, there was nobody even close to Hannah. I told Hannah, it looked like at that point in time she was about to touch the rim. Like, that's, she just has a great desire and a great ability to make plays.
You obviously only had 1-3 at halftime, I guess, coming into the half. And, you know, when you talk to your team, was that something that you, you know, wanted them to get a little bit more looks for?
Well, South Dakota State's a great defensive team, and they weren't giving us many opportunities. We had a hard time moving the basketball, establishing ourselves inside, you know, got a couple in transition or kind of early offensive type of looks, maybe when they were not quite matched up at that point in time. So tough to get them against them. We had a hard time getting them at their place. We had a tough time tonight or today. I don't know what day it is, time it is. Sorry about that.
And Chloe kind of started that second half pretty high, got a couple shots to fall, kind of gave you guys that little bit of a cushion that you held throughout the entire second half. How big was that?
Yeah, Chloe makes plays. You know, she's such a tough competitor, you know, and I think it's, again, I think it's really special for these three because they wanted it so bad, and that's why they came back. But because you want it so bad, it sometimes gets in your own way. And then there's the other part of it that it almost, at time, if you win it, it feels like it should be a relief. And it didn't feel that way. There was pure joy, and that was really fun for them. So I'm glad they had a chance to experience that. I thought their mindset was really good.
When's the last time you've seen or been involved in a game that's so defensively intense for both teams the entire game?
And yeah, that was
tough. How much is that,
huh?
A testament to your team?
The good news is our fans understand the cheer for us when we're on defense, so we appreciated that. We need a little extra help on that side of the court.
Got one in front here.
You mentioned just some of the joy at the end of the game, but, you know, has this sort of become, you know, obviously three straight now, has this sort of been the expectation of the program, especially with this group largely similar?
Well, there are eight teams who are here that want to do the same thing, that want to cut down the nets and want to have an opportunity to play in the big dance. And so, you know, to be able to get to this game is really hard to do. You know, we really had to battle. I thought UMKC played a great, great basketball game yesterday, and it was a struggle, you know, and a battle to get to this point in time. So first of all, you get here. You know, that's after playing Western Illinois, and that's a back and forth battle the whole time, and had a lead, and then they cut into it, and then it's tied, and then we're behind. I mean, so it was, the first part is it's tough to get to this game, and the second part is, you know, then it's tough to win it, and it's tough to win it when you're playing against someone who is great on both ends of the court. I think South Dakota State is one of the best teams in the country in scoring the ball. They score 80 points a game. They score at a 53% clip. They shoot it. I mean, the way they shot at the beginning of the game, I thought, man, this is going to be tough. And so, you know, you're playing against a great offensive team, but they can also defend at the same time. And so, yeah, we just feel really fortunate that we were able to come out on top.
And there were a couple plays that Grace made, one with the shot clock winding down where she got her own offensive rebound, and then at the end of the third quarter with the lay-in at the buzzer. I mean, to have a freshman in this type of environment step up like that, how big was that?
Well, and the best part about it was she was running the point guard spot so we could get the ball entered and make a play, and she couldn't really get it entered. I think she went to the wrong side of the floor, and then she was like, well, I guess I got to just make something happen. And so the great part is she just – has the ability to make things happen, and she has a great demeanor about doing it. And, you know, I think, again, we had an opportunity during the course of this game, and it doesn't really show up in a stat sheet with Allison Poplowski and Janai Ugovsky and Macy Giebert, you know, and Grace Larkin's playing really, really important minutes for us. And that's going to be important for their growth moving forward.
We'll take one last question in the back here.
Don, Eric Mayer with Kellyanne News. How great a showcase was this of just South Dakota women's basketball in the state?
Yeah, that's a great question. Certainly, I think the fans for both teams, you know, made this an environment that girls dream of playing in an environment like this. And I think the Summit League and all the people that put time and effort into running this event. It's first class. It's second to none. And, you know, and everyone from the staff here at the Denny Premier Center, it's really, really well done. And so our ladies are going to have an opportunity to tell their kids about this. You know, I had a chance to coach in the Big Ten and be at the Big Ten Women's Basketball Tournament, and this environment is just so much different. It's really, really special, and we don't take that for granted. So we really appreciate all the fans. I really do mean that sincerely, even the ones that weren't cheering for us, because it is something that's really special for our young ladies to look back at and have those memories and have all the video and all the pictures to go right along with it.